Call the meeting to order. We have two public hearings on the agenda tonight, and then the budget adoption update. We'll go ahead, open the public hearing on the proposed tax rates for calendar year 2018.
Mr. Vice Chairman, I have no speakers for the first public hearing.
Okay. Close the public hearing. That being said, Mr. Bryan?
Yes, sir. Mr. Chairman, with regard to the tax rates, our recommendation is you defer this action of adopting these tax rates until the April 10th regular meeting, and then at such time, go ahead and adopt them. I know our treasurer is ready to prepare the bills and send the first half installment for real estate, which these real estate rate will be set upon. So really no action for you to do tonight.
Okay. In that case, could I have a motion? Or do I need a motion?
No, sir. I've already have it placed on your agenda for next week.
Okay. Very good. With that being done, we will move on to a public hearing for proposed operating and capital budget for fiscal year July 1, 2018 to June 30th, 2019. Public hearing's open.
Yes, sir. We have two speakers this evening. First is Dr. John Davis, representative of Germana Community College.
Thank you, Mr. Davis. I'm John Davis. I'm Vice President for Administrative Services at Germana. I'm pleased to come and talk to you this evening. Presented you a packet of information that's got some PowerPoint slides for your information. Wanted to first thank you for meeting our proposed request in the upcoming budget. I appreciate that very much. It's going to help us tremendously. The slides I have you gives you some information, demographic information about the students that come from Orange County attending Germana, sort of who they are, what they look like, and what they're studying, if you will. And I wanted to highlight a few things that we're working on. As you know, we have a new president who came on board last July, Dr. Jan Gullickson. And we are really moving forward in a lot of partnerships with our K-12 partners, including here in Orange County. We're developing, working with the counties to develop what we call educational pathways, which is what the community college system is moving towards in the state. Sort of a longer view of education, sort of a K to sort of 16 pathway, if you will. And we're working with the public schools, including Orange County, to make that happen. As you know, we have a career coach embedded at Orange County High School. There's a college employee who works and helps students and helps sort of guide them in their next stages. Looking forward, we plan to expand apprenticeship-related courses in the county, continuing our partnership and meeting the county's needs in any way we can. Most interest to you is the fact that we have recently been approved by the state to move forward on the planning of our new campus at Locust Grove. The original campus was built in 1970. It is very near end of use, and we have been approved by the state to enter into the planning and engineering stage for that building. That building will be approximately 65,000 to 70,000 square feet. About three stories in nature. It'll be a sort of a L-shaped building that will exist currently where there's a big group of trees. As you come in on the driveway to the left, next to the parking lot is where the new building will go, and the existing building will be raised. And then some of the historical aspects of the land, including some of the Confederate trenches and other aspects that were torn down when the campus was originally built in 1970, will be sort of resurrected and preserved. So we're looking forward to that. That campus will be focused on allied health, so the nursing program, it'll be state of the art. And so we're really looking forward and partnering with Orange County and moving forward in any way we can to bring that building to fruition. Any questions that any of you might have? just again want to thank you so much meeting our request. Thank you.
Thank you.
Next speaker is John Lyon, representative of the Orange County Education Association.
Good evening, gentlemen. How are you this evening? I want to thank you for, first of all, I want to thank you for your service to Orange County, and thank you for, as a school employee, for giving me a job. It's very much appreciated. But beyond that, I'm here to speak to you guys tonight about the importance of, you know, fully funding the school system. And there seems to be some variety of disconnect and a bit of confusion between the information that, you know, I keep receiving from different ends of things. So Chairman Whitehead responded back to me in an email that I had sent to each one of you gentlemen. And he had said that there was proposed $925,000 of new local money that was, you know, being offered to the school system. And that would be fantastic. We could very much use that to help us bring the amount of pay that our employees receive up to a level in which that makes us competitive with surrounding school systems. As one of the things that latest studies in employment show, teachers just aren't coming out of colleges that much anymore because they can, you know, people that go to college, they can get jobs elsewhere and other aspects of the economy where they can really, you know, they can make better money. So the desire to go forth and, you know, help young people achieve better to promote the future of the community seems to be overridden by, I might be able to make $15,000-$25,000 more a year coming out of college. And, you know, when you're facing student loans and things like that, that's a kind of tough choice. As one of my members indicated to me, it's interesting that teachers, they want us to have master's degrees, and we should have them. It's great. You know, you want the best qualified teachers in the classroom at all times. But, interestingly enough, other professions that require master's degrees, teachers get paid 79 cents for every dollar that those other professions get paid that also require master's degrees. I found that to be very, very interesting. And, you know, of course, all you have to do is turn on the news, read the newspaper, and you will see that in today's climate, there are states, Virginia's not one of them, but there are states where teachers are walking out of their jobs. They're going on strike because they're fed up. They're tired of working 2, 3, 4-plus jobs. You know, I have a member that she came to me on Friday and said, I don't know how long I can stay here in Orange because I can't afford to pay my rent, pay my expenses, pay my bills, and, you know, and keep this job when I could go to a neighboring school system and, you know, make upwards of $5,000 to $10,000 depending on the school system. So that's one of those big struggles that I know that the schools here in Orange County face, and localities everywhere face these decisions. I wouldn't want to be where you guys are. I'll be honest, it's not anything that I would want to do. Not that I don't think it's an important job or anything like that. I just don't think I have that kind of wisdom. I'm an academic. I belong in the classroom. I belong there helping shape young people and helping them to achieve things for the betterment of the future of our community. And as I said before, I'm very appreciative to Orange County for giving me a position in its school system where I feel it is awesome school system. We have a lot going on that is positive, and I want us to continue moving forward. And if there is any way that the Orange County Education Association can be of benefit to you gentlemen in the future, I would welcome that dialogue. I would welcome that partnership. Thank you so much for your time this evening.
Thank you.
speakers?
No, sir.
There's no more speakers. We'll close the public hearing. I'm sorry, Mr. David.
Yes, sir. Now on to the budget, and if the board allow me, I'll just kind of dive into the second item on tonight's agenda is the status of state budgets and things. This operating budget, as I recommended last week at your regular meeting, Dr. Tanner and I have been in discussion. We think because of the General Assembly special session, Governor Northam has called them back April 11th, that it's advisable just to defer consideration of this budget until your April 24th meeting. That way we should have, if they adopt a budget, and we have every reason to believe that they'll work their differences out between the Senate and the House and the governor, we will have more numbers. We will be disseminating those numbers to members of the board and certainly the school board from Dr. Tanner's side. As far as school funding, this also, there's implications in this for the constitutional officers, social services, CSA, the list kind of goes on. And so with Ms. Bradley's help, we'll try to bring to bear whatever those state funds and how they help, hurt, or neutral on the county's general fund budget. And so really, at this point in time, there's nothing much for you all to do but to defer this to the 24th of April meeting. And there's no action. We'll just take it up at that time. One other bit of housekeeping. You all have canceled. You had scheduled a work session for this Thursday, April 5th. You have canceled that. So I just want to make sure there's public recognition of that. And so nobody come here on Thursday because the board won't be here to do any more budget.
Okay. Very good. Is there any further business?
We were talking before the meeting about the possibility of reinstating the work session April 10th to discuss the six-year road plan.
VDOT's finding money.
Yeah, since we actually have, I mean, we're not used to that, but we actually have to make some decisions about which roads to fund. And as I understand it from Allison, Alan is expecting us to come back to him with some roads, and then he's going to run the dollar process.
I know she was talking dollars and talking to him on the phone just an hour ago a half hour ago. Sure, we'll reinstate the work session at 4 p.m.
Does that work for everybody?
Sure. Yeah, and you and I are on at 3 then?
Yeah, I guess we'll get bumped back to 3 again. we're swinging back and forth there depending on
what. Is that with Kurt?
With Kurt.
Okay. Is that okay with you, Kurt?
Sir.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, all right, on the new building. So, okay, so we're going to reinstate. We do have business. VDOT has money and
wants to use it. That's amazing.
And we want to take it before they change their mind.
Well, soon it's testament we'll see water running uphill in Orange County and cats chasing dogs.
Yeah. I've seen cats chase dogs. I've never seen water running uphill.
Okay, so we'll have the 4 o'clock work session. Next Tuesday, and we'll send the media notices and do all kind of that reestablishment. Susan?
Yeah. I'll make a motion to adjourn.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye.